Sandwich. So today, I'm going to feature three different types, four different actually, we went to four. We have the Bella Lady Cheddar. We have the Pepper Jack from Spring Hill Creamery. We have a Marin French Brie. And today we're going to make a grilled mac and cheese, grilled cheese sandwich, which if you have not had one, this will change your life. So today, it's really fun. I picked cheeses that we can all find around the country, a cheddar, a hot pepper jack, a brie, and the mac and cheese, which we're going to show you how to do. We made the mac and cheese a few weeks ago, so the recipe is on our website if you would like a nice selection of mac and cheese recipes. So over here, I have the cheeses in their whole form. The brie, we have bacon, which we're going to add to the mac and cheese sandwich. So we're doing a mac and cheese, bacon, grilled cheese sandwich. And we have the pepper jack, and I'm going to serve that on a nice sourdough bread. And then we have the Cousteau multi-grain bread here. Cousteau Bakery is in Healdsburg. So we're gonna do the multi-grain bread with triple cream brie and fresh pear slices. And it's so delicious. We're gonna do the mac and cheese with crispy bacon. And then we're gonna do the pepper jack. And then the tomato season, I would add sliced tomatoes to that. And the cheddar is a great base for anything you have in your refrigerator to use up. So today, I'm gonna turn on the butter to start grilling our sandwiches. But I know we all open our refrigerator door and we have an array of condiments in our refrigerator. So I have found making grilled cheese sandwiches is a great way to use up the condiments. When you have 2 tablespoons of a jam left, you might have couple tablespoons of a red pepper tapenade or a sauce from dinner the night before, or this is our arugula green pesto. And this is a great way to use up those condiments, a little bit of jelly, maybe one of the mustards. You can add charcuterie to your grilled cheese. I mean, grilled cheese, there's no boundaries with grilled cheese. And so it is American Cheese Month. So it's U.S. American Cheese Produced Month. So every day on my Facebook page, I write about a different cheesemaker from around the country. And I have not picked my selection yet today, but I will. And yesterday I picked Gordon Edgar from Rainbow Grocery Co-op. He may not be a cheesemaker, but is a very fiercely loyal cheese supporter. So here I'm melting a little bit of clover butter. I have a tablespoon of butter in each pan. Just gonna spread it around. And let's start with the grilled cheese. I'm using a hamburger bun today because there's no reason you can't use a grilled hamburger bun. They taste delicious. And they're kind of the bun that usually sits on your shelf after you've made your hamburgers and you have a few left over. So this is a great way to use it up. And what I do when I put my grilled cheese in, I flip it over first to absorb the butter on both sides. And that way you have an even distribution of the butter for your breads. And you can use any bread you have. Ben, can you bring me that loaf of beautiful bread that Maggie Pat made us? So I'm starting the grilled cheese mac and cheese here. And I'm going to show you a trick momentarily. I'm going to turn the cheddar one over here. So this loaf of bread our neighbor Maggie Pat made for us, we dropped off some flour. And the benefit of having flour in the catering company is our neighbors bring us these fresh, delicious homemade breads. So this would make a delicious grilled cheese sandwich. So I'm gonna flip this over again to get the butter distributed. So we're getting the cheddar. And one of my favorite breads to use is the Hawaiian sweet rolls. Make a delicious grilled cheese sandwich. I'm gonna turn this heat down a little bit. So Oz, do you wanna open up the questions from our guests today if they have any questions regarding the ingredients?
Yeah, I was just checking. Don't see any questions so far. I think everybody's just super captivated.
Yeah. So if you all don't mind, I'm going to put another sandwich on here. I'm going to put the brie. And then I personally like to add the peppers after, or the peppers, pears. But Ben, we also brought little peppers, papadou peppers, which are delicious. Just a few little pickled bites with your grilled cheese sandwich can really enhance the flavors of the cheese, the breads, and give a little pop. And then over here, I'm going to add the pepper jack cheese, Ben. Stack it just for a second, get myself a little bit more butter. So what's fun about making grilled cheese is there's really no wrong way to make a grilled cheese sandwich. I mean, Oz, does Augie make his own grilled cheese sandwiches yet?
He does not.
Well, we're gonna have to work on that.
Yeah, we got a special chair for him that you put up in the kitchen, but
oh nice.
Yeah, by the time it hits 5, I think he'll be on it.
So what I did up here in the front is I have fresh pears. Once I've got my brie sandwich toasted, I add the pears, and I like to have the chilled flavor of the fresh pears and not get too mushy and have a nice firm texture with the soft melted brie. When we had a cafe, this was probably our most popular sandwich, was the grilled brie on custard multigrain with pear slices. So I'm just going to keep these from flipping. So over here, if I move up here, does that work, Ben? The way to get a shape of your mac and cheese for your grilled cheese sandwich is put your mac and cheese in a quart container or a mason jar, and then it flips out. So you refrigerate it overnight, or at least for a couple hours, and then it flips out, and you can actually slice it into rounds for your grilled cheese sandwiches. It's also a great way to make grilled cheese. You can actually grill the mac and cheese on the grill, like slices like this. And it's also a great way to serve it, slice it, and then serve it as a mac and cheese round. We do that in the catering all the time. This mac and cheese this week is the Daisy Cheddar from Bella Cheese and Point Reyes Blue Cheese. So every week when we do our food delivery service, we make a different mac and cheese. Oz, you'll be getting some of that.
Most definitely looking forward to it.
That's the beauty. Oz gets the benefit every week of getting the extras from the cooking class. So thank you.
I won't get as much of this one, though, because Oz will get first dibs. We had a comment that the with the bacon is inspiring. Mac and cheese sandwich with bacon is inspiring or inspired. So they are inspired off bacon. Bacon almost
makes it
better.
Let's add that bacon in. Always. I can't think of a person, unless they're vegetarian, that wouldn't like a grilled mac and cheese with bacon sandwich, Oz. So over here, I'm going to turn this off. I have my cheddar perfectly melted. Well, Ben, I could use a chef knife. Ben is, not only does he film, but he can retrieve anything from the warehouse here. One day, maybe next class, we'll do a virtual tour of the warehouse. Not today. So I cut them in half. And then, I mean, you could theoretically add your bacon. You could add more cheese, some fruit. You know, serve it with some green salad, some greens. I have some lovely, beautiful greens, Ben. We have beautiful greens from Kicking Bull Farms. We could add a few wedges of greens onto the grilled cheese. We have a green radicchio, which I had never seen until today. I didn't even know a green radicchio existed. Coming back to my station. Okay, these ones are all done. So I'm gonna add take the grilled mac and cheese. Put it on here with the, right here. So now you can see the pre-cooked and now the perfectly delicious bacon mac and cheese. Then I'm gonna take the brie here.
And add Ben, in can we get a close-up tour of that, please?
Oh yeah. So there you go, nice fresh pears, brie. Who wouldn't love a fresh grilled pear and brie sandwich? So over there, and then we have our pepper jack, which I'm going to take the liberty to add in some some roasted red pepper tapenade. And this recipe is actually on our website too, on the recipe page. We put this up a few weeks ago. Roasted red pepper tapenade. You can add some capers in here right now. I mean, it's really the sky's the limit. If you have some charcuterie slices left over, you could really do whatever you'd like to create a delicious grilled cheese sandwich. Any questions out there? Anybody have a favorite cheese they like to use in their grilled cheese? One of my favorites is Tasso ham. If you can get the Cajun country ham, we do Tasso ham, the cheddar cheese, and a side of Creole mustard. That is one of my all-time favorites to make at home. Truly one of my favorites. So anybody have any cheese questions? Cheese?
No questions thus fresh bread. Far.
Don't be afraid to use an English muffin. English muffins make a delicious grilled cheese sandwich. And in the summertime, add some nice slices of tomatoes, some red onions. I love a red onion confit, like a caramelized red onions are delicious. Balsamic glazed saute red onions is also delicious. Fresh scallions. Fresh green onions can add a nice fresh flavor to the grilled cheese sandwich if it's rich and creamy and heavy in flavor. But Ben, did you see the final three sandwiches there for them? We got the grilled mac and cheese with bacon. I think that's coming your way, Oz. The grilled pepper jack with roasted red pepper tomatoes, the brie with pear, and the mac and cheese where we would add the bacon into it. So
it looks fantastic, and I'm looking forward to it.
So don't forget the trick about your mac and cheese. You start with the quart, refrigerated overnight. And, you know, you can use the fancy mac and cheese, but, you know, you try making the Annie's mac and cheese and put it in a container and then flip it out. It can be a half size, 16 ounces. But it makes the perfect round for your disc for your grilled cheese sandwich. And I put out some capers. You could, please.
We have a question. The recipes, where will they be available?
So the recipes for the tapenades are already on our website at theepicureanconnection.com under recipes. And then today, following this class, I will send out a follow-up email to all the registered attendees that they'll list the cheeses that we serve today and a link to all the recipes for the tapenades. Good question. Thank you. So locally, it's always fun to use our locally based cheeses, the Spring Hill Creamery, Bella Cheese, and Marin French Cheese. And all three of these companies have mail order too. So I just wrote an article about wine and cheese. It's on our website and our Facebook page, featuring Sonoma County produced wines and cheeses that are available to ship across the country. So that was a fun little project to write about for the Sonoma County tourism, where the promotion is bring Sonoma County to your home. So kind of fun to make those recipes. I don't know if anybody's seen those yet, but they're on our Facebook page. And you can follow us on our epicureanconnection.com and get our weekly newsletter. And each week it has a link to the coming Zoom class on Wednesdays. In June, they'll start to be on Thursdays. We're going to move our Zoom classes to Thursdays at 11. And next week, we have Zingerman's Creamery, Ari Weinswig, joining us from Ann Arbor, Michigan. And him and I are going to talk about food and cheese and Zingerman's and the Zingerman's leadership training course. I hope any of you have time to join us. Ari is a wealth of information. Ari Weinswig, wealth of information. And our giblet fell asleep, Buzz.
So it was mesmerized. It was dreaming of bacon like I am.
Thanks.
And so let's see. Yes. Everybody, in case you're yodeling, go ahead and take a little break. Let me unmute everybody in case somebody else has a question that they'd rather ask. So everybody should have audio now. I'm going to pick on Joni, my mother-in-law, and Patty, her sister. They're joining us today. Ladies, any grilled cheese questions?
Is Patty going?
Yeah, no, I was just going to ask about Havarti cheese.
Oh, Havarti makes a delicious, creamy grilled cheese sandwich. Keep in mind, the Havarti melts rapidly, so definitely slice it thick and pull it off the griddle right before it releases, and that's what makes Havarti delicious, is a high cream content. Havarti makes a delicious, wonderful grilled cheese sandwich.
All right, that's good information.
And also made the mac and cheese.
What a red pesto, a red tomato, a sun-dried tomato pesto work?
Absolutely. Sun-dried tomato, roasted red pepper. When we had our cafe, we would make grilled cheese sandwich and we had like 12 different options of the tapenades on the side. So absolutely. And this is really use up the little bit of capers you have and the little bit of roasted red peppers in the jar in your door, your refrigerator. It's a great way to use up your pantry.
Right. Good. Okay. Thank you.
Of course.
Thank you, Joni. Thank you, Patty. Anybody else?
I also can assemble your grilled cheese sandwiches ahead of time, wrap them in plastic wrap. So if you're busy, but you're going to make grilled cheese sandwiches, make them in the morning, wrap them in plastic. They'll be fine for 24 hours. We used to do that at the cafe, make them up in the morning for the evening. So you just simply make the bread and the cheese. And then just when you're griddling them, add a little butter and grill them on the pan. So it's also a nice trick if you're going to have who doesn't want to have a grilled cheese party? But, you know, if you have teenagers in your house, you'll definitely need more than one grilled cheese sandwich. So it's a great way to make them ahead of time and also a fun way to make a variety of grilled cheese sandwiches. Any other questions? I always like, one of my favorite is ask where everybody's calling from.
People saying thank you, well, and people look forward to joining next week. Jill Hunting is from Pasadena. Joni is from Capitola.
Hi, Jill.
And Patty's from Livermore.
Excellent. Well, thank you all for joining us, and we hope that you'll tune in next week to learn about the Zingerman's a family of businesses out of Ann Arbor, Michigan. And I'm Sheana Davis, Oz Robledo in the tech world, and Ben is filming. So thank you all for joining the Epicurean Connection. We look forward to seeing you next week.
Bye, Sheana. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you all.